Hi guys, welcome back. In this video we're going to take a look at pop-ups in MailChimp. So first let's go to our list, then let's choose our sign up forms, then you scroll down and we'll go to subscriber pop-up. This is the initial form that there is for the pop-up. So if we come here to preview pop-up, this is the design that you'll get initially. So it will just look like this exactly if you embed it on your web page. So I'll close that. The different types of layouts are here. You can take one whereby the forms are like that and there's an image up there. You can take one where the image is on the right and the form elements are on the left. Where the image is on the left and the form elements are on the right. So I'll choose this one. Then I'll see if there's anything else I need to change. You can change the font if you wish to. You can change the color of the text. If you want to give a different name to the button, it's okay. You can do that here. For example, if you want to say sign up or get it now, this is where you'll change that. You can change the text color here for the button. You can change the background for the button. You can change the hover color for the button. You can align the elements. Left is okay for me. I want the button to be full width. The model styling. So if I want to change the color, I will do that here. If I want to change the overlay opacity, I will do that here. I think 50 is okay. At least that will make area behind the model window visible. So what you mean is this here, you can see this is an opacity of 50%. So if I increase that to maybe 90, you'll see it won't be as visible. Yeah, so that's what the opacity is. So I'll put mine at 40. So that's for the fields and the layout. That's for the design of the form. Then I'll go into fields. Keep in mind that we have this layout whereby the image is on the right. The form elements are on the left. Moving on, I'll go to fields. Then only email is being shown. I want the first name there. I also want the second name there. So I can make it required by clicking there. So this will be required. That's it. Then I'll move to content. As you can remember, the element here, which has 450 by 400 px. That is the suggested dimensions. So for me, I don't really mind. I'm not going to be using this, so I can just choose the image that I had earlier uploaded into my MailChimp file manager. So I'll choose this, I'll select it. So the body, you can see something here. Let's say subscribe to get the best free video courses. So that will appear here. That's where the body element is. You can add a link here just by writing something, selecting it, clicking there, and then you add your link here. This is familiar from when we were working with embedded forms. So that's it. You can also add if you want something on the footer. So you can see there. If you want to put something, maybe some terms and conditions, you can put them under here. Here on the footer, it will appear down here. So that's done for the content. Then let's take a look at the settings tab. In the settings, pop-up delay, do you want it to appear immediately? Not really. I want it to appear after 2 seconds. marks pop up width, you'll be overriding the recommended width for the model. So I think 980 is pretty wide, but let me just leave it there. This is good enough. So I will just come here and publish. Before I do that, let's preview our form. So it will be something like this. If this is what you add to your website, it will be something like this. Then I will publish the form the way it is. Then I'll view the code. I will copy the code, Control A, Control C. Well, if I put this code into a WordPress website, it's not going to work. I don't know why that usually is, but it doesn't work with WordPress until you do certain hacks. So I'm going to use a pure HTML file that I'd created, the one we used for our first demonstration. So I want to put the code in the footer. Let me increase the size. Since this is on my computer, I'll need to add then we'll preview it on Firefox. This is how it will appear based on how you designed it on your MailChimp account. If you're putting this on a pure HTML page, or you can try putting it on any other page, it will work fine. With WordPress, if I put this code on the footer or the head of the header.php or the footer.php, it's not going to work. The other way we'll do it will be via a plugin. So we'll use a plugin for WordPress. I know most people use WordPress, so you can find out which other plugins or modules are there for your CMS. If you're using Drupal or you're using Joomla or whichever, just find out which other plugins are available for you guys you can use. For WordPress, you're going to use a certain plugin. We'll see it in the next video. Okay. If you've been watching the entire course step by step, by now you're good with MailChimp, and there is nothing you wouldn't be able to learn and do on MailChimp. Like the videos, share the videos, and subscribe to my channel. Until next time, guys, see you.